Hello students and everyone, welcome back to class 8 maths on my YouTube channel. We will begin chapter 1, rational and irrational numbers, on text 2, page number 4. Decimal representation of rational numbers. If we use decimal fractions while dividing the numerator of a rational number by its denominator, we get the decimal representation of a rational number. For example, 7 upon 4 is equal to 1.75. In this case, after dividing 7 by 4, the remainder is 0. Hence, the process of division ends. Such a decimal form of a rational number is called a terminating decimal form. We will divide the number 7 by 4 and we will check whether we will get the remainder 0 or not. 4 ones are 4. 7 minus 4, how much? 3. Put the decimal point. And on quotient place also you have put the decimal point. 0 you have to bring it down. 4 sevens are 28. 30 minus 28, how much? 2. 0 you have to take. Then 0 you have to bring it down. 4 fives are 20. 20 minus 20, 0. 7 upon 4 is equal to 1.75. If the numbers are divisible by divisors after the decimal point, then it is called terminating decimal form. By putting decimal point after the number 7 and continuing division, I got the remainder 0. You can continue the division by putting decimal point till the remainder gets 0. We will talk about now non-terminating recurring decimal form. In non-terminating recurring decimal form, the division will be continued after the decimal point without getting the remainder 0. For example, if you divide 7 by 6, you will get the quotient 1.1666. After the decimal point, the digit 6 is repeating. If the digits are repeating after the decimal point, you have to put the line on top of the numbers, which numbers are repeating. If one digit is repeating after the decimal point, you have to put dot on one digit. After dividing 7 by 6, the quotient is 1.1666. The digit 6 is repeating. On top of 6, you have to put the dot after the decimal point. After putting dot on top of 6, you have to stop writing 66. So the answer will be 1.16. Let's take another example. We will divide the number minus 5 upon 3. 3 ones are 3. 5 minus 3, 2. Take the decimal point 0. Put the decimal point on quotient place. 0 you have to bring it down. 3 6 are 18. 20 minus 18, 2. Take another 0. 0 you have to bring it down. 3 6 are 18. 20 minus 18, 2. Take another 0. 0 you have to bring it down. 3 6 are 18. 20 minus 18, 2. The division keeps on continuing after the decimal point and will get the same remainder. You are not getting the remainder 0. If the division keeps on continuing after the decimal point and the remainder, you are getting the same number after subtracting, then such a decimal form is called non-terminating recurring decimal form. The question was minus 5 upon 3. So on quotient place it will become negative. If the question is given negative, then on quotient place you have to put the negative sign. That is equal to minus 1.6. On quotient place, if the digits are repeating after the decimal point, you have to put the line on top of the numbers. If one digit is repeating after the decimal point on quotient place, you have to put the dot. That is minus 5 upon 3 is equal to -1.6. If you understood terminating decimal form and non-terminating recurring decimal form, give us the feedback or comments. Subscribe the channel, like and share. Thank you.